For more than three decades, Samuela Akilisi Pohiva represented the people of Tonga, and today the people have come to say goodbye.
One of his few last words and his concerns was just not about the family, it was about the people. First, take care of the people. Secondly, take care of the royal family. And third, love the people. So he's really a man of the people.
Many will always remember him as a man of the people.
For the people to have the farewell today, it's very emotional. It's sad because for the PM, he's done a lot of things for the government.
What we see here today, despite the political differences in our beliefs, but the people still choose to come and join the family in mourning the not just a prime minister, but a father.
Hundreds have gathered at the centenary church in Nuku'alofa for the late prime minister's state funeral. Today was declared a public holiday and a national day of mourning.
He was politically very cunning, and I say that in a good way. He knew where people's thinking and people's hearts were. And so much of his oratory and much of the things he did resonated with where people were at.
But in the last few days of his life, it wasn't just his politics that was challenging. He also battled with his health.
The family, relatives, and friends, even the country mourns the passing of a great man, and it is a great loss.
The Prime Minister's body was flown back from Auckland earlier this week. School students lined the streets to show their respect.
I just felt honoured to see everything today. I don't have the right words to explain. So sad at the same time. We're just happy that he's in a better place.
It's sad, like saying farewell. This will be the last time for us to see him in person.
Tonight, the Prime Minister will lie here in state at the St. George Government Building in Nuku'alofa, where members of the public, dignitaries, as well as the royal family will have a chance to say farewell.
It's the end of an era, but the beginning of the next chapter in Tongan politics.
We need strong leadership, and especially now with the death of our Prime Minister, there will be a void in that leadership.
Akilisi was Tonga Tapu One's people's representative, and that position will go through a by-election later this year. Electing the new prime minister will come down to a secret ballot in the House.
To pass away in the middle of your work is, in a way, a little bit tragic, but you can see the man, you know, he was on a mission, and for better or for worse, he actually changed Tonga.
Akilisi was instrumental in the 2010 political reform that eventually led to the first democratic election.
Definitely, as you look back in the last 100 years of Tongan politics, no man has emerged as distinguished as him in Tongan politics. And he passes away with that legacy.
It's this example that has inspired another generation to continue the Pohiva legacy.
I've already made the decision. I run for the next election and move on. It's big shoes to fill. I cannot replace him, but I will try my best to pursue, to leave the legacy, to follow the principles that he has lived.